We're now going to use the inverse function theorem to figure out what the derivative of arctangent of x ought to be. So the inverse function to arctangent of x would be x equals tangent of y. Now that's something we already know how to take the derivative of. Dx dy then should be secant squared of y. All right, so what does that mean? According to the theorem over here, if we want dy dx, that should be 1 over dx dy. So dy dx ought to equal 1 over secant squared of y. So that's great and easy and everything, but the problem is that we need x's and we have y's. So this is where all of these inverse functions get interesting, especially when they're trig functions, because we need to put back in here, instead of a y, an expression in terms of x. So we know that x is equal to tangent of y, and we're going to use the fact that tangent squared of y is equal to secant squared of y minus 1. That means that secant squared of y is equal to tangent squared of y plus 1. So we can replace the secant squared of y here in the bottom with tangent squared plus 1. Now we're close to being able to go back to terms of x because we know that x is equal to tangent of y. So we get 1 over x squared plus y, replacing tangent of y with x. And that's the derivative of arctangent. Now we can use the same method to take the derivative of natural log of x. We've taken this derivative in a previous video using straightforward implicit differentiation. But now we can make it a little bit quicker by using the inverse function theorem. So we know again that if our function is natural log of x, then its inverse is x equals e to the y. That means that when we take the derivative, we get dx dy is equal to derivative of e to the y is y, e to the y. So according to the theorem over here, dy dx is 1 over e to the y. And we know that e to the y here is x, so the derivative of natural log of x should be 1 over x, which is exactly what we found it to be in a previous video. Now we're going to use this inverse function theorem to find the equation to the tangent line of f inverse of y when x is 1, even if we don't solve our actual equation for f inverse. So what do we mean? Well, according to this part down here about a particular point, we want the equation of the tangent line of f inverse of y when x is 1. Well, first we better figure out what y is. So f of 1 is 5 times 1 squared plus 1 equals 6. So our y value is going to be 6. And 1 is our x value. So whenever you're trying to find a tangent line, you need both a slope and a point. We've got our point. Now we need a slope. Slope we're looking for is going to be f inverse prime when y is 6. So f inverse prime when y is 6 is supposed to be the same as the derivative of x with respect to y evaluated at y equaling 6, which is supposed to be the same as 1 over the derivative of y with respect to x evaluated at x equaling 1, which is going to be 1 over f prime of 1. So what's f prime of 1? Well, that's 1 over 10x plus 1 evaluated when x is 1, which is 1 over 10 times 1 plus 1, which is 1 11th. Now we have our slope. So with our point and our slope, we can find the equation of the tangent line. Now this is where it gets a little bit weird. Because we're working with the inverse function of y, in this particular case, we have x as a function of y instead of y as a function of x. So our tangent line, our point-slope form of a line, is going to actually have to be x minus the x value equals m times y minus the y value. So we're going to get x minus x value of 1 equals 1 over 11 y minus the y value of